Hello, everybody. My name is Alvaro Sabu, and today we're going to learn how Storyblok helps you out to translate your content and how you can use the SDKs to fetch the correct content depending on your user language preferences. So let's dive in into the world of I18N.
But excuse me, sir. What in the world is I18N? Is that the Star Wars drone?
That's a good one, but no. Actually, I18N is an abbreviation of internationalization, so let's say it's the lazy or efficient way to say it.
Oh, now I see, but what's that?
It's just a set of best practices and processes to make localization easier. Let me show you. But if you would like to follow the same steps as we do in the tutorial, I recommend you to create a free account at storyblok.com. There are three main options for managing multi-language content in Storyblok. We have field-level translation, folder-level translation, and last but not least, space-level translation. Keep in mind that this decision depends entirely on your content strategy. These decisions should be made after considering all the pros and cons of the different options. Storyblok can store multi-language content on the field level. What it means is that you're only going to have one content tree, and you will not need to create a standalone folder for each language. This is a good choice if the structure of the content in different languages is the same or really similar as the one in your default language. You will have fewer stories to maintain, and the system takes care of serving the correct language every time. To set up field-level translation in our instance is pretty easy. We just need to go to the settings of our space, and then select the Internationalization tab. Inside here, we're going to see a section that allows us to see the languages that we have configured. Right now, we only have the default language. To add a new language, you just need to go here to the dropdown, and let's say we want to add German. So once you select it, you click Add, and then we have it on our added languages. Notice that here you're going to see the Unix code of the language and the region, and then the name or the label of the specific language. Let's add another one. Let's search for Spanish, and somewhere here we're gonna find the Spanish one. You can also add language variations by region. So if we want to add French, we have the option as well to add French from Canada, French for Belgium, or any of these other variations. For this specific example, I'm going to use the Belgium one. And let's click Add. Once you have them, click Save, and now your space is available in these different languages. Let's see how we can change the language on our Visual Editor. Now that we have configured different languages on your space, you're going to notice that in the Visual Editor, you're going to have a tab here that allows you to change the languages. These are the languages that we set up in the previous part. So, to make field-level translation, you need to enable the fields that you want it to be translatable. In this case, I'm gonna select the headline and edit the field. Inside of the field configuration or the block library, you're gonna see a point here that says, checkbox that says translatable. This is the one that enables toggling between different languages on the field level. So if it's not already checked, please check it and save your field. Now, I'm going to select a different language. In this case, I'm going to select Spanish. If you change the language, you're going to notice now that the URL has been adapted to the new folder or the new language. This language is going to be retrieved in your frontend by using the SDKs and then send it into the API to know that the content that it needs to be retrieved is the Spanish one. Here, I'm going to toggle this toggle here that says translate, and now I can add the translation of that field. In this case, I'm going to say una aventura en el espacio. Once I click save, now we have a translation for that specific content in Spanish. Notice that not all the content has been translated, because with this approach, you will need to go field by field and translate the content yourself. If I also go to a different language, for example, German, now I will need to translate the field again into the new language. So as we mentioned before, the field level translation is great whenever the content structure doesn't change that much. But it can add a little bit or more manual work, since you have to translate field by field. Sometimes translating only the content is not enough, because if you notice here, we are in the Spanish translation, but the slug of this page, which is personalized landing page, is not translated. We probably would like to have a translated version of this string, meaning something like landing page personalizada. So how we can do that in a Storyblok? If we go back, we can go to our app directory. And in the app directory, there is a tool in translation called translatable slugs. If you install this one, and then you go to your content again, so personalize the landing page, and then you go to entry configuration, you're going to notice that you can change the slug into different versions depending on the language. So for the Spanish one, I could go here and say, hey, this is landing page personalizada. And I can also change the name into a translated one. Landing page personalizada. Yeah, it's true that the landing page is not the best example to translate because we use exactly the same one, but página de entrada, I don't know. The personalization one is the one translated. So when you save and close, now you're going to see that your slug is using the correct language. You're now probably wondering how you can use that language that is in the URL to fetch the correct data in the Storyblok. So it's as easy as this. Right now I'm using a code example from Nox on one of the dynamic routes to get the language and query the story by using the SDKs. So we have this URL for our content, and this is the one that is pointed to the French Belgium content or the French Belgium translation. So what we were going to do in our dynamic page here, or dynamic route in our front end, is that we're going to take the route and then we're going to get the parameters here, and we're going to get the language and the URL by separate. Then we're going to use async Storyblok or the SDK function that provides for Nox. Okay, and we're going to pass the version and also the language. So in this way, we are actually passing to the SDK that we want the content from France, Belgium. There are two apps in the app directory that can help you out with the workflow on the field level translation. And those are the export translatable fields and import translatable fields. These are great whenever the team that is doing the translation, let's say an external team, it doesn't have access to your Storyblok instance, but it will require the labels to be able to translate. So what you can do with export translatable fields is that all the different fields that are set to translatable can be exported in a more friendly format, such as JSON or CSV, normally is the one that is used for translation teams. Then they can do their work in their Excel files, create all the translation, and then you can import them back into the system without that many manual effort. If you would like to have a more insight or more depth explanation on this application themselves, let us know in the comments and we can create a tutorial about it. If you want to dig deeper into this topic on how to implement it with the SDKs and the frontend, I suggest you to watch the videos that we have prepared for you on how to implement this on a real project. Folder level translation uses separate content trees for each one of your languages. Folder level translation is a great choice when the structure of your stories is different depending on the language. It could be used as well to differentiate regions and markets. It is preferable when the content for different languages is managed by separate teams, or your project structure differentiates a lot between different markets. To exemplify how we will use folder level translation, I created a folder here that resembles the North region market of your product or your website. Okay? So let's say you have a different audience in the North or a different team that is working on that content. And then you have this folder and you have an about page inside. Okay, So the about page is pretty simple. I just added a hero section and a grid section just below. Okay. So how folder level translation work is that instead of going one by one and changing the fields into a different language, you already have the different folder here on the URL, differentiating between the north region and let's say the south region, okay? So if we want to create another folder, okay, that is gonna contain our south region, we can go here, create south region, create. And now inside of it, we can create the about page. We can also do it by going and duplicating this one, okay, and targeting a new folder. In this case, we're going to target the south region, okay, and we're going to duplicate it. So now we are in the north region. Let's go to the south one that we just created here. And then we can change more than just the fields. We can actually select different stuff. So the south doesn't remember. And we can also add a button here and read more. Change a little bit the style to secondary maybe. And let's say that this market doesn't have this grid section here with different prices, but instead of that, it has just a banner. So we can actually remove the block and use a completely different block from our block library. In this case, I'm just gonna use a banner. So top five discoveries. Okay, if I click save, now this page for the South region is gonna contain this content right here. It could be even the same language, or you can actually say El Sur no se acuerda, and in a different language, okay? But when you go to the North region, your page is gonna be completely different. So this type of localization or the differentiation between pages is useful when you have different teams that create different kind of content, and also the structure or layout of the page is different. You have different components that you want to use in the North region or in the South region. So this North region could be also as well a language like DE or ES, but in that case, it's important that you don't have the logic in the front end to use the language, okay? There are cases that you want to mix both full level and field level translation, but in this case, I just show you how to do it only with full level translation and the default language. Before we jump in into space level translation, there is an app in our directory that makes things easier for you whenever you're using folder level translation. This application is called Dimensions, and it allows you to manage in an easier way multiple tree structures for different languages. So all you need to do is install it here, and then let's go back to our content. I'm gonna select again the North region about page. And what we are gonna do is create another folder here in the root that is gonna be the West region. So let's create West region right here. Great. Okay, so with the dimension app, what we can do is here, we're in the North one, and if we go to more here in dimensions, we can see that we haven't created a clone of this page in the West region. So if we hit create a clone and then we enter that clone and we were here, we're gonna notice that it duplicates all the content that was available on the North region, meaning that it has the same hero component and also the grid section. So this allows you to create, for example, if you are gonna open a new region, you can take your available content already in the default language and duplicate it into the new one so the team can work on it. Here, I will just need to just change here and say West Coast, for example. Save, and now I have a specific about page for the West region. So the Dimensions app allows you to create clones and also overwrite the existing story in the folder with the current story. or you can also merge the changes from the selected story. If you would like to have a specialized video about the Dimensions app and all the features that allows, let us know in the comments and we are going to suggest it to the team. Last but not least, we have a space level translation. And this one is just exactly that. It's creating a space for each one of your languages. You can have one content repository for your fallback language, for English, for example, and then you can create another one for the translation in Spanish. This is actually useful whenever your application or your website is quite huge, and for organizational level, you have different teams, different content, and even different kind of designs or different frontends for your different languages. So this one, it doesn't have any more magic on it. It's just basically that the content in this one is going to be translated into Spanish and this one in English. Something that you can use to minimize the effort is using the Storyblok CLI to duplicate content and also share components between the different spaces, so it makes things easier. Thank you all for diving with me today into Storyblok internationalization features. In the description below, you can find all the writing resources that we mentioned on this video. Hit that thumbs up if you find this video useful, and don't forget to subscribe to get more content like this. If you have any question, feel free to drop them in the section above, and also you can approach us in the Discord channel. Ciao, ciao!